Greetings, I'm Stanley Elford, American Dream. We're here from our guest in just a moment.
This is WGLS Rowan Radio.
And welcome again to the American Dream. I'm your host, Stanley L., and we have part of the Dream Team here. Not sure where press pause is, but yay. At least we have the one and only fantastic Christy Morales on. Of course, the gentleman of honor, Mr. Travis Wolf. I mean, you can say something, right? Are you muted out? I mean, what do you mean?
Oh, I'm talking, but I haven't muted my mic. Great day, everyone. Great day.
I mean, embarrassing, you know, they have to read lips. You read my lips.
It's a different kind of podcast. It's a different kind of television show.
Travis, show I mean, you're here, and our guest is someone that obviously you have met and recommended on the show as one of the guest of honor that we have. Why don't you introduce your guest? Because it sounds like she fits right in, but I want to give you the honors to introduce her.
Yes, absolutely. Everybody, this is Sarai Quinice. And, you know, Sarai is a very, very special individual. Her spirit is just, it's not what you are used to seeing. It's not something that's normal for many of us. So it's always good and refreshing to meet someone whose spirit aligns, you know, and who's striving to do great things in this world. I don't really know Sarai that well, but actually we're in the same space as actors in the entertainment industry. And I've met her recently we had a table read together, and just, you can tell she was just different. Her light was different, her presence, her enthusiasm, and then learning about her mission and what she's striving to do and what she wants to do for youth and what she wants to do in the world, spreading God's light. It's just, it's amazing. So I really would love to hear more from her and allow her to do the honor of really introducing herself and what she's really about for our guests. But that's my take on her, but I'm sure she could do a better job.
Okay, Sarai.
Well, hi, everyone. My name is Sarai Quinice. I am now a 19-year-old actress, singer, dancer, model, serial entrepreneur, motivator, and inspirer to youth. I love to motivate and inspire the youth. I like to let them know, you know, they can be their best selves wherever they are, whenever. And it's just about how they go about that and executing their goals and just using their talents and their beliefs and whatever they want to do with their life, just making sure that like they're happy every single day. So, yeah.
So that means you're happy every single day.
Yes, I strive to be happy every single day. We only have one life. So, you know, we have to make the best of it.
Well, you know, we only have like, you know, so long, because we can have a 2-day conversation on that topic.
Yes.
No, seriously. I mean, I'm the kind of person that believes, not only believes, but I accept that every moment in life is supposed to be rejoiced.
Yes.
That's why you're here. I mean, why would you want to do anything else with it? Of course, that's why you're here, because we need people to know that. Where and how did you kind of get your start on that particular path?
So, I found my passion acting at a very young age. I was saved when I was 6 years old in my private Christian elementary school. It's called Cornerstone Christian Academy in Southwest Philadelphia. So I was saved there, but I really didn't know the meaning of like having God and having a relationship with God. But as I got older, I got re-saved freshman year of high school. And from there, you know, I felt, because I actually understood what it meant. So from there, I had that walk with God. And then he was also strengthening me in my talent and my number one passion, which is acting. And I took a class at John Grace Productions, and it was acting. It was the acting series part one. And he had a a class where we were just focusing on our spiritual selves, because, you know, when acting, like, you bring in a part of yourself to that character. You automatically, like, you create the character and then you bring yourself into it. So with that spirituality class, we had to take a spiritual test. So it was like this test. It's called spiritualgifts.com. I just took it recently, and my gifts changed. And now I know that my gifts are teaching, leadership, giving, and administration. And I know that because, I mean, like, I've been walking in the purpose for so long. And what I've known about acting is that, you know, I like to comfort people. I like to heal people. I like to let people know different perspectives of the characters, because you know, ultimately, the characters that we play, the characters that actors play, are real people. So, yeah, I just, like, with acting, I want to draw to the audience. Like, I'm a pupil person. So, I like to engage, and I like to reflect with them. I like to teach them about certain beliefs and different topics and everything through my art. So, yeah.
Excellent. You're, in my mind, exactly what young people should be today.
Thank you.
I say that because I look at the generational experiences that I've had, you know, being young and having ideas and things of my own, and then watching our children grow up and with their own ideas and things. Mm-hmm. And in my mind, by the time we get to where we are today, young people should be that advanced. It shouldn't take you to get through elementary school, high school, senior high, and college to come to the conclusion that I'm a spiritual being. It shouldn't, you know, and of course, with technology advancing the way it is, we should be ahead of technology, not behind it. So right. That means as an individual, there must be something greater in us that should be coming through at this point. And so I look for what you represent in every young person. Right. Christina, you know, you're here, you're female, you're all about God. What's your take on what Sarai is sharing with you?
I love it. Absolutely. I actually, at a young age as well, discovered that I was a spiritual being. And, you know, I trust in God wholeheartedly with everything that I do. And when I was baptized in the waters, like, that changed my whole life. I mean, I just had a whole different perspective. So, like, you starting off at 19, amazing, you know, and you're helping other people. What would you say to young people who haven't been found yet?
Keep searching, keep exploring. Ask and you shall receive. That's one of the reasons how I got on this platform, because, Mr. Travis's wife, Miss Diana Wolf, she actually messaged Mr. Travis about it. And, you know, that was just God right there. So, and I put it on Twitter, and then I reshared it to Instagram. And I'm like, Lord, like, I know that I have a voice. I know that I have a voice. And I know that I have a bunch of youth looking at me right now, looking up to me, following me, all of that. So I just want to strengthen my voice so that I can reach more youth.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
The question I have for you regarding youth is the support behind them. And I'm going to take a guess that you must have a strong support system, family and so forth.
Yes. My mother. So my dad is not in my life, but that doesn't hinder me from doing what God called me to do. I have a strong mother, a praying grandmother that just beat COVID-19. And then I also have my stepmom, it's a bunch of women, a bunch of Black powerful women that are around me. And, I also have mentors. Mentors is better than anything that, you know, money can buy, honestly, because knowledge is power, you know, and, you know, like, if you have a whole bunch of money, or like being rich or being wealthy or whatever, and you don't know what to do with it, there's no point of it. You know what I mean? So, but once you have that knowledge, you want to make it stick with you. So, a bunch of women around me, they're very, very strong. They teach me life lessons I have a spiritual mentor. Her name is Ryan Killebrew. Also, I have a great community with within John Grace Productions. And my grandma, she just prays for me over and over and over again. And it's all just like flowing. It's flowing like great. So.
Yeah. Yeah. See, I can see that just because you're such a natural. And it would take, and what I mean by that is, if you have a strong support base behind you and you're born into this world with that new glow up, mm-hmm. obviously you have a natural tendency to be that person because right. of the support. You're reflective of the people that are around you, right. as opposed to someone that doesn't have that base. They're reflective of those behaviors and, you know, influences. Mm-hmm. What do you say for the ones that do not have that kind of support base?
I say, to one, explore, start asking yourself, what do you want? Don't say, you know, I can't have it. Just how am I going to get it? If they don't know God, I would say try to reach out to people. I know that, you know, some may not be confident, but it's about, you know, your enemy is your inner me. If you ever heard that saying, I'm pretty sure you have. But you have to get out of your head and just be confident in yourself. And, you know, the worst that anybody can say to you is no. But if they see your passion, if they see your drive, then they're going to want to help you. I tell that to youth, like, all over my platform, and even some people that I actually talk to, like, personally. And I'm like, you know, you have to believe in yourself before anybody does, because how are they going to help you if you don't want to help yourself? So it starts within yourself. And that's how I started with this journey, because you wouldn't want to have me on the platform if you didn't know anything about me. But this is why I put myself out there and I broadcast what I do. And I display the talents, the accomplishments that I've been having, the support that I've been given. So, you know, people, they have to break this barrier of I can't, or having their doubts and worries, and just put yourself out there, because the worst thing anybody can tell you is no.
No, I love your thinking, Shirai. I do love the way you think, and I love your message. I want to expand upon it a little bit, if you don't mind. I mean, you say that the worst thing anybody can tell you is no. I know you mean it this way, that it's almost the best thing that anybody can do is tell you is no. For me, when I was in college, I'll give you an example of what I'm talking about. When I was in college, I was ready to leave college to go get the job that I wanted to have my entire life. Since I was 7 years old, wanted to be a police officer since I was 7 years old, get to college, try all these other things. I tried criminal justice. Well, I didn't try it till last, but I tried computer engineering. I tried broadcasting, telecommunications, mass media. I tried sports and recreation management. I didn't love anything, but I knew I wanted to be a cop. I said, let me just do what I love. I started doing criminal justice, and I started getting 3.5 grade point average, and I was struggling through college the rest of the time. I didn't love what I was doing. And when I finally got the job offer to be a police officer, after attempting and attempting and attempting and being told no 14 different times by 6 different police departments, I finally got a yes. And when I went to get in the department, my father said to me, if you don't go to college, I mean, if you don't finish college, you're never going to come back, right? You're not going to do it. And I'm like, that's exactly what I needed. You know, I needed somebody to tell me I can't do something. Like you said earlier, people tell you that you've got to get out of this mindset that we can't do. And he told me I couldn't do it. And I was motivated to do it. When I got told no 14 different times, Every time I got told no by another police department, it motivated me. It just motivated me. I just kept showing back up, trying again, and it motivated me. So I think that no can be, if you look at it with that type of perspective, the no is the motivator, right? So right. I would encourage people to, there's a book out there, I don't remember who the author is, but it's called Go for No, right? I didn't read the book, but the title fits this situation, because for me, I almost go for, you know, that no, because I know after I get past that no, there's a yes there somewhere. There's a yes there somewhere. So I know people like to say no in this world. We get told no way more than we get told yes. But for me, it's all yes. That no is just a course correction, right? So right. Something to kind of get you back on a different path. Maybe no, not this way, but no, another way. And for me, it's all experience gained, whether I get told no or not. So
I think
I like the way you think.
I'd like to add to that too, because what I've learned, I've been working with young people for a long, long time, you know, growing up and then going right back to high school, right after graduating, going right back to high school and doing events and things and constantly working with you. And what I'm learning even more so today is that the no is such a motivator because the kids want to be challenged. They like the challenges. You get a bad, you know, butt kid and challenge them saying, you're nobody, you're this, that, and the other. What are they going to do? They're going to prove you wrong. They don't just sit down and go, oh, okay, I'm going to take, you know, take this licking. No, they'll get up in your face, you know. And I think that's something that a lot of populations, when I say that word populations, I'm thinking about white, black, Hispanic populations, the educational institutions, when they're teaching, for example, they're not necessarily challenging the kid. They're just doing what they do. You know, and the kids are on the phone or they're doing whatever they want to do. The minute you go after them, though, what happens? get off the phone or hold on. You know, and I look at that as a positive thing. I don't look at it as a negative thing. I look at this kid. You know, I mean, he's like ignoring you the whole time in class. I'm in the school system. So he's ignoring you until you challenge him for what he does. And then all of a sudden he opens up. Can we direct it? I believe so. What do you think?
I totally agree. I agree. Me, you know, I've been through challenges and stuff. Like even in school, I've always been the one to kind of like stand out. Like at first I looked at it in a negative way because people would like say that, you know, like I'm weird or, you know, like she's different, but you know, all of like that mattered to me and that really like hurt me like emotionally in elementary school and then a little bit in high school. But like once I got out to college and now that, you know, we're living in the world and I just realized that like the thing that the most successful people, those are the ones that stand out. So I'm kind of happy that I'm weird. I'm happy that I'm different and I'm very, very blessed that I am that I'm standing out.
Absolutely. You wouldn't be unique if you did.
Right.
You know, it's funny because we're all individuals. I mean, I always have to put that out there. I mean, are we supposed to be alike if we're individuals? I can't, there's no logic in that.
I think that being weird is beautiful, to be honest, you know, because everybody's unique and I know I'm weird. People in theater, obviously, you know, you have to play different personas, but you love it. And everybody loves you for it. So proud and kudos to you.
So where's the new normal?
Right, exactly.
Okay, I just got the high side from our engineer, Carlton, over there. So we're going to take a break and we'll be right back after this.
Welcome back to The American Dream. I now present to you Beyond the Barriers with Stanley L.
Whether you're raising a family, advancing a career, building a business or a mission from God, victory lies beyond the barriers. Have you ever thought what it would be like to create a flower? What about a beautiful musical bird or star that dances in space? Think deeply upon this. Imagine the joy you could bring to a little child or the hope you would bring to someone in need. Oh, the love that would manifest about you if you were to bring forth such wonders to life. I trust you can see this with me, the joy, the love, and the happiness you could bring. Hold that feeling. See the picture of such extraordinary joy expressed by those you love. It would be worth any effort to be able to bring such happiness into this world. Visualize what you would like, wielding. You would be like wielding such extraordinary power, power that could only come from a love so tremendous, so supreme, that the substance of creation would act instantly at your command. what love would you be? What feeling would you express? Your appearance would have to be a radiant or as radiant as the sun, striking the ripples upon a flowing stream. Your being would glisten like diamonds, and all would adore your every move. I am the strength that carries the power to move forward steadily through all experiences, wherever they may be, and to remain joyous and uplifted, filled with peace and harmony at all times, by the glorious presence which I am.
The American Dream, reality on Rowan Radio, 89.7 WGLS-FM, with host Stanley L.
I believe in the United States of America as a government of the people, by the people, for the people, whose just powers are derived from the consent of the governed, a democracy and a republic, a sovereign nation of many sovereign states, a perfect union, one and inseparable, established upon those principles of freedom, equality, justice, and humanity, for which American patriots sacrificed their lives and fortunes. I therefore believe it is my duty to my country to love it, to support its constitution, to obey its laws, to respect its flag, and to defend it against all enemies, everywhere, forever.
The 25th Principle of Liberty states, peace, commerce, and honest friendship with all nations, entangled alliances with none.
And that concludes the American Dream. I'd like to thank you, our listeners and viewers, for sharing your time and attention. And of course, Sarai, you are a very, very special person. And I learned that through other means, not just today. But I certainly love your radiance and the power that you bring and the love you bring and the joy you bring and the sparkles you bring to the American Dream. So you have to come back.
I will. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. Now, I know you're in Philadelphia, are you?
Yes.
Okay, and where about in Philadelphia?
I'm in Southwest Philadelphia.
Southwest Philadelphia, so you're probably even closer to us than normal, you know?
Yes.
Southwest side. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, we'll have to get you over to Woodbury, New Jersey, and let you talk to some of our youth.
That's fine. I'll do that.
All right, sounds good. Chrissy, any final words?
I just want to wish everyone a blessed and safe and healthy week. And special shout out, as you all saw, my cat Moana, who is also co-hosting today. And everyone be well. Thank you.
Travis?
I just like to thank you, Sarai, for coming on. It was definitely a pleasure to have you. I love the way you think. And just, I really want to encourage you to continue to seek out people, individuals like yourself, who have that positive mindset, who are willing to do greater things. And I want to challenge people like yourself to continue to go out there and find those youth and reach out to them and give them the knowledge and the wisdom. Like you said, knowledge is power. And of course, applied knowledge is power. So we want to help not just reach out to those youth and give them the information, but help them to apply it. So grateful for you. Thank you for coming on the show.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Sarai, I'm going to give you the last encouraging words to share with the audience.
Be your best self and be great. Go be great.
All right, sounds good. Carlton?
Travis.
And this has been the American Dream on Rowan Radio 89.7 WGLS FM. As always, have a great week, everyone.
American, the beautiful.